Good morning, welcome to my Silver Sneakers Flex Pilates class. I'm Olivia. Let's get started. Today I'm just going to ask you to stay standing for a moment, and I'm going to show you a new trick that I learned about how to get yourself to stand up straight. And so you imagine you put a jacket on, and it's a short jacket, so the zipper comes right here, and you're going to connect the zipper, and you look down, and then as you zip it up, you straighten out your spine, you come nice and tall. All right, beautiful. And then I have a woman in my class I just taught, and she was telling me she's a singer. She used to teach music in a school. And she said, we used to say, get your ribs out of your lunch. Isn't that great?
That's cute.
I just love it. I just love it. All right, come to your mat. Let's sit down and get started. So zip that. I don't think it's easy. I really like doing it standing. It's a little more challenging when you're seated, especially if you have tight hamstrings and hips, you'll need to take your legs out in front. But let's do sit tall on your mat. Maybe move that fleshy part of your seat out of the way to really connect the sit bones with the earth. Fingers alongside. Let's just take a nice deep breath in. This is going to help you sit up nice and tall. In through the nose, out through the nose. And sometimes I like the image that you're trying to breathe. Smell the chocolate chip cookies that I've got in the bag. I really don't.
Yeah.
So breathe as if it were your job. Shoulders down, fingers are resting out far. Let's creep the fingers back a little bit more. So the heart lifts, the shoulder blades draw towards the tailbone. In. Now exhale, tuck that tailbone underneath you, tuck the chin, look towards the navel. Inhale, come right back up, slide the hands up the thighs, lift the heart. Exhale, scoop the belly around. So a little seated cat and cow never hurt anybody. Exhale. And inhale. All right, right arm comes over. I'm just touching here. Watch the I don't care. We're going to do more. Drop the shoulder around to the ground. Come to the center. Scoop the belly and roll back up. And then we'll go the other one. Doesn't matter which one to me because we're going to do both. Over to the ground. Come to the front. Scoop the belly and roll back up. Again. Exhale. Give it a little massage. And then the other side, same thing. All right, and then let's take the mat. Hip width, the feet, hip, mat width apart. I'm gonna drop the left knee down to the right, and then the right knee down to the left. What's confusing is my socks say right and left, so I can't look at them. Sorry. I know, I would, but then they don't do the right thing. Yeah, in fact, when I first bought them, I put them on wrong. I don't know if you've done that for years. And the feet are like, what's this going on? Yeah, it's weird. All right, so let's take the feet out in front. We'll continue to warm this low part of the body up with just a half roll back. It's going to be a two-breath cycle. Take a deep breath in, nice and tall. Exhale, scoop to the, roll back to the tailbone. And then on the next inhale, you're going to let that belly draw further away from the thigh muscles. And then inhale, come back up. All right, deep breath, nice and tall. Exhale, scoop. On the next inhale, scoop the, get the C shape, even more C, and exhale, come back. Four more with your own breathing rhythm. There's the exhale. There's the inhale, scoop. Exhale, come back. Exhale. Inhale, scoop. Deepen that C curve. One more time. And then just push on the gas and brake. Let's cross one leg over. Just a little twist away from that foot. Take a little stretch down the fascia. And then we'll go to the other side. Same thing. Cross that leg over. Twist away from it. And all the way back. Again, get that fleshy
part out of your seats. We're going to sit up tall. Bend the knees as much as you need. I'm going to hinge at the hips. I'm going to bring my heart forward here with this nice straight zipped up spine here. So until you feel this little lengthen in the back of the legs, you take it as deep as you want to. And then I'm going to place this beach ball right here in front. You're going to sweep the belly and round over it. Forehead drops towards the earth. And then using the hands, roll the spine all the way back up. And then we're going to roll the spine down from here. So hands are going to slide back. You're maybe going to catch the elbows, eyes on the toes, all the way down. And then let's just take a nice stretch. From the fingertips to the toes. Find that. All right, soles of the feet on the ground. Hands alongside of the body, that classic Pilates position, and now we're gonna take that classic Pilates breath. So press the pelvis into the mat, all right? Draw the navel towards the spine, breathe laterally into the ribcage. In through the nose, out through the mouth. With that nice, strong exhale, you're going to blow that feather back up. Really engage those core muscles when you do that. In fact, at the bottom of that exhale, that pelvis should press firmly on the mat. You are really imprinting it down. One more time. Relax, take a nice deep yoga breath. And notice everything gets kind of soft and squishy in the belly when you do that, okay? That's what I want to happen. Okay, and then just tipping the head over side to side, like you're trying to lower one ear towards the ground and then the other. So stretch in the neck, side to side. And then back to the center now with your nose. Draw a figure eight right on the ceiling. Down, around, up, and over. Down, around, up, and over. A little more neck work we did not get when we received it. One more time. And back to the center. And then tuck the chin a little bit. So you're going to get a little nice long neck. And then just exhale, release, and look to the ceiling. Take a deep breath in. Tuck the chin, and exhale, look back to the ceiling. Nice and easy, inhale, tuck the chin, let the shoulders draw away as well. Then exhale, one more time, tuck the chin. And exhale. All right, hands alongside the body now. Remembering, we're gonna keep this Pilates breath going. We're gonna lift one arm over your head. Now what I want you to be careful you don't do is let the rib cage pop up. So you're gonna keep the rib cage down as you inhale and then exhale, come back. And then the other side, inhale, keep that rib cage reaching towards the back of the mat and right back down. And inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Very smooth, very connected. Notice the ABCs of Pilates, alignment, breathing, concentration on your core, stabilization of your joints. So we have stabilized everything but this shoulder joint that's moving. One more time. And down. All right, so now we're just gonna take one leg out to the side and let it come right back in. We're gonna stabilize the pelvis now. So as that knee drops out to the side, you're gonna notice that nothing's gonna move. Here's a good way to see if you're moving. That's to put the thumbs on the hip bones and the little fingers on the ground. And you'll know if you start to slip off of that hip bone, if that hip is moved. So continue to press, imprint that pelvis into the mat and let that one knee drop to the side and then the other. It's not gonna go all the way to the ground, I'm sure of that. It maybe goes 45 degrees, maybe less. Yep. And again, other leg stays facing the ceiling. I've separated these two so we have time. As I often put the hands with. And right back up. One more time. All right, bring that right knee into the chest. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, maybe curl away from the mat. And then inhale, extend the legs, extend the arms. I'm going to
to circle the knees around, tuck the chin, maybe curl away from the mat. You don't need to. Inhale, arms over your head, legs go long. Exhale, tuck the chin, round away. Inhale, we lengthen. Exhale. Inhale, we lengthen. Exhale. Put that leg down and switch to the other side.
The inhale is when you're always lengthening the body, so if that makes any sense to you, try that. Take a nice deep breath in. I'm sorry. There we go. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, come right back in. Inhale, find length. Exhale.
Again, try not to let that rib cage pop up.
And exhale.
So even though you're trying to get that breath in, I'm going to continue to press the rib cage into the mat.
Yeah? Watch the ribs don't pop. I don't want to see rib bones up there.
Okay. Let's bring both knees in. The knees out towards the shoulders, and then bring the knees back over the hips. So you're going to get a little bit of a massage on the low back as you bring the knees in. You open them, and then right back down. So the pelvis is going to rock here a little bit. Let that happen. Give it a little massage. Chin, and we're going to bring them back together, maybe extend them out. So it's going to be a little similar to what we just did. Arms over, knees into the chest. Exhale, circle the arms. Rolling down, tuck the chin. You can roll up or you can keep the head on the ground. That works for me too. Inhale, the knees come in. Exhale. There's the crunch, there's the work. Inhale, the knees come in. And exhale, you can always just take them to the ceiling if that feels better to you as well. And circle. One more time. Curl away from the mat, arms go long, legs go long. And all the way back in, bring the knees in, drop them to the mat. We're going to roll the hips up and just relieve the hip flexors there a little bit. Roll the spine back down. Now let's take the 100. All right. Again, this is a breathing exercise, so you can keep the head down here. You can keep the feet down. You can take this at any level you want. What I want you to focus on is the contraction that's going on in the ribs,
not the shaking that's going on up here.
Okay, that needs to stay nice and smooth. So pick your poison, as I say, or pick your experience. Take a deep breath in, drop the chin, and find wherever you're going to be. Take a smooth inhale, and find that sharp exhale. And rock and roll all the way onto your belly. And so we warm up the low back as well. Keep your feet about hip distance apart. It's a little easier, a little safer on the low back. And the hands are going to come along about lined up with the face, forehead, tip of the nose on the mat. Now give your hips a toss side to side. You don't want to use the hips when you do this, all right? This is all going to be the low back. And it's going to be a small movement. On the first inhale, I just pull my navel towards the spine. On the exhale, I'm going to lift the upper body. I'm not using my hands, I'm using my back. On the next inhale, I pull the navel towards the spine. And then exhale, release back in. You don't need to crank the head up. You're just lifting away from the floor. Deep breath in, belly in. Exhale, flex and lift. Inhale, draw the heart forward a bit more. Exhale, back down. Inhale, belly in. Exhale, flex and lift. You'll feel that in the back. Deep breath in. Exhale, back down. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale again. Exhale down one more time, just like this. Breathing in, no legs, no arms, all back. Breathing in. Exhale, release back down. Rest, turn your face to the side, give your hips a toss side to side. Lifting, take a deep breath in, and then exhale, let both feet lift from the earth. Now I'm going to tap my heels together. If you feel this pinch in the low back, don't do it. We're going to tap 4, 3, 2, 1, and open. Again, 4, 3, 2, 1, open. Two more times, 4, 3, 2, 1, open. One more time, 4, 3, 2, 1, open. And then a little flutter kick, as if you were in the pool. Breathing deep. One more Pilates breath. Release the legs down. Give them a toss side to side. Let's let them rest. Okay, the one we did at first was that breaststroke prep where we just lifted the upper body. Now we're going to try breaststroke. So we're actually going to use our hands a bit here. We're going to come up for one inhale and lower back down on the exhale. So we take a deep breath in, lifting up. You're going to use the hands. Exhale, come right back down. Now your flexibility will tell you where to stop. The hips are going to stay on the mat. Inhale up and exhale back down. Let's try not to crank the head up. Just lift the heart. Inhale. You are going to use your hands on this. If you've ever had a herniated disc, this is part of your therapy. And I think what's happening is you are mechanically squeezing that bulging disc back in. That's an interesting thought. Inhale. Exhale down. Get a little arm work here. One more time. Inhale. And exhale. All right, are we ready to lift to plank position? Hands under the shoulders. I'm going to stay on my knees. Push up just to plank position. Hold it. So pick my hands underneath the shoulders right there, and I'm on my knees. I'm going to come forward and back here. There's a little bit of a stretch, and then come forward. Watch you not letting the hips fall here. All right. Forward and back. And then think to move the hips around a little bit. So over to one side, around to the other side, over to the front, and back. So I'm making a big circle around here. Shoulders get involved, if that feels good to you. Again, one more time. All right, so now we're gonna drop back into child's pose. Keep the knees facing straight ahead. That gives you the best low back stretch. If you want to take the big toes together and knees out, gives you a little more hip stretch. But right now, we just work the back. So let's keep the knees coming straight ahead. Now, your choice. If you need to keep your hips up a little higher, that's fine. I want you to work at trying to rest the forehead here. Hands on the ground, right in front of the knees there. And we're going to take, now this looks an awful lot like child's pose in yoga, but we're going to call it shell stretch. In Pilates, and that happens because of what we're going to take some breath work right here. So what I want you to do is engage the pelvic floor, pull the navel in towards the spine. I want you to breathe into the back ribs. So expand through the back. And then take that good strong exhale. And if your ribs are on the thigh muscles, on that exhale, you will feel them draw away from the thigh muscles. So we take that nice deep breath in. Get rid of as much breath as you can. One more time. Full deep breath in.
Creep the hands out in front. Come into that plank position. And let's just try this for a moment. I'm gonna slide one leg out. Now, this is all you need for plank position, then by all means, stay right here. The tailbone draws towards the heel, so the hips are not gonna come up. Maybe slide the other one out. Take a breath, lift the front body to the back body. Drop the first leg, drop the second leg, and come into all fours. So walk the hands back here. Okay, so cat and cow, why not? Heart moves forward, exhale, scoop the belly around the spine. And you can come onto the fist if that feels better for you. You may want to rock the hips back if you're a little more on your knuckles. And you may want to rock the hips back. There's a little less pressure on them. Works best for you. On the inhale, you may want to tuck your toes. And on the exhale, you may want to drop the feet down to get a little chance to stretch through the toes. One more time. And back. Swing your feet over to the right. Tuck your chin towards your right shoulder and look for your feet. Arms are straight. And then we'll go the other way. Feet over to the left, tuck the chin to the left shoulder, get a nice side stretch, arms are straight. All right. And then, you know how we were circling around this way before? Now we're gonna circle the rib cage like this, all right? So, I think Lauren used to call this the elephant. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna slide the rib cage over to the right, drop it down by the mat, come over to the left, and then dome the back. Arms are going to stay straight here, so it's sort of like those shoulder push-ups that we do, or scapular push-ups, I guess you call them. Over to the right, drop down. Are you getting that? Maybe I should do it this way for the camera. And again. Interesting thing, huh? Get those ribs moving. Let's switch and go the other way. See if that feels any different, if that's more difficult to do. Try not to let your head drop. Look towards your fingernails. One more time. All right, head back to the center. Okay, let's come into spinal bones. Slide that right foot out and just catch the mat. I will never not enjoy a little bit of a calf stretch, particularly now, so enjoy that calf stretch first. And then lifting that front body to the back body. You can't see it with this shirt on, but I'm doing that. Let that foot leave the earth, right? I'm pressing out through the heel. My foot is flexed. Upper body is perfectly flat, and I'm going to let my left fingers creep forward. Should you find balance, turn the thumb to the ceiling and maybe lengthen. Now use that right hand. Press it into the mat. Yes. Only a choice. Breath in. Exhale. Elbow and knee underneath you this time. Scoop. Round. Inhale, find length. Maybe that foot's going to stay on the ground this time. Maybe the fingers are staying on the ground. Doesn't matter to me. But elbow comes in. You can drag that toe in. I like to do that too. Two more times. Beautiful. There you go. All right, rest that down. Spend another moment with the calf stretch. And then let's drop back into child's pose. And I'm going to say lift the elbow, the hands up, and get a little circle on your wrist there. Okay, another side. Same thing. Hands under the shoulders, knees under the hips. We're going to slide that left foot out and give yourself a little bit of a calf stretch there. You can always benefit from a little extra calf stretch. So just enjoy that. And watch, my tendency is to let my head fall down so I'm looking at my knee, but look just beyond the fingers on your mat. Foot leaves the earth. You're going to squeeze that glute, lift the front body to the back body, slide that right hand out if you find balance, and that leg extends, arm and leg are extending. Deep breath in. Here we go. Exhale, elbow and knee together underneath you. Now, what I like to do sometimes if I need my balance is I'm going to slide that foot on the mat. All right, so feel free to do that as well, and then find that length. How lovely is that? Beautiful. And one more time. Inhale, find that length. Hold that there. Lift that front body.
toe, nice calf stretch. Back to all fours, back to child's pose. Again, circle the wrists, wiggle your fingers. Breathing deep. All right, before we come over onto your side so you can see me first. All right, so my elbow is gonna be right underneath my shoulder. If this is gonna give your shoulder trouble, feel free to go down onto your side. That's okay. It'll be a little different exercise, but that's okay. Then, extend that top arm to the ceiling. And now I'm going to lift the hips from the ground. Now, you may stay with that knee bent. You can also extend that bottom leg up. What I'm going to do is I'm going to pulse my hips up. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Circle that arm underneath. Inhale. Comes right back up. Again, circle it underneath. Inhale up. Let's use the breath. Exhale down. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. One more time. Inhale up. Lift that top leg and pulse the leg. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. One, all the way down, like a one too far, huh? Come all the way down, take a moment's rest, let's come on to the back. We'll take the first ab series, and that's the single leg stretch. You can put the foot on the ground, you can extend the leg out, you can bring the head up. But what I don't want you to do is yank on the legs. And I want you, I like this image as well. I have put you in about an inch of water, okay? So every time you bring that leg in, there is no movement in the torso. You want to try to keep no ripples coming out of the water, okay? So let's just use that image. Come into classic Pilates position first. Take that deep breath in. Okay, on the next inhale, tuck the chin. If you're peeling away, go ahead and do that or keep the head down. Smooth inhale, sharp exhale. I'm just touching my knee and ankle. Doing this for some reason, I don't know, but yeah, nevertheless. Right. Elbow right underneath the shoulder. You can bend that bottom leg if you'd like. I'm gonna reach the hand up and I'm gonna lift my hips, pulse up. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, working your obliques, 3, 2, 1. Here we go, we're gonna reach underneath. Deep breath in, exhale. Inhale. Notice that shoulder comes across your body there. I think two more. I think I can six. One more. All the way up. Now I'm going to lift that top leg. And here we go. Pulse. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All the way down onto your back. We'll take the next one, which is the double leg stretch. This is where you take your sombrero off. And your choices are hands on the ankles first. Your choice is here, 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 wherever you'd like, with your head up or your head down. Again, nothing moving in that little pool of water you're in. So take a deep breath in, tuck the chin. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. We're going to try 8, so pace yourself. Notice that pelvis is pressed. pressing down into the mat. Find length in those legs. Extend, extend. Reach them as far as you can, like you've got to touch that wall. Grab hold of that hat and take it off. I think two more. Give your little hips a ton of side to side. And you maybe even a circle and get a little massage out of there. Alright, so we're gonna rock and roll and get ourselves back up or over onto your side, whatever feels best. Feet to the center. And I'm gonna come this way. So I'm gonna take my feet about mat width apart. We're gonna take spinal twists. This is three twists. This is a classic Pilates exercise. It starts with that nice tall spine, right? And if you need to bend your knees to do that, you can even do that with the knees in. That's okay. The key is to this a nice straight spine so that every time you turn, that spine goes taller and straighter. Think of that. I also like to use the image that your spine is the center of a spiral staircase. And so if you tilt those stairs, somebody's going to fall off of them. So you want to keep this nice and straight. Okay? Spinal twist. Arms can be out. Arms can be out, can be here, doesn't matter to me. We take a nice deep breath. Three little twists, a little exhale. One, two, three, come back to the center. On that third, get rid of all the breath. Deep breath in. One, two, three. Come back to the front, lovely. Be sure the feet aren't doing this. Nice, deep breath in. Exhale, one, two, three. Back to the front. Lovely. One. Back to the front again. One. And back. All right. Release. Let the arms rest. I'm going to turn to the side. Oh, you should probably turn to the side. Feet to the center. Okay. We're going to take this half roll back. Hands here. I have my left hand on top, and I'm going to lift my left knee, take a deep breath in, and exhale. I'm going to extend and turn to the left. Inhale, come back. Let's go the other way. Exhale. Inhale, come back. I'm switching almost as if I'm going to pull my hand that way. Exhale. A little more oblique work. Deep breath in. If that doesn't work, go ahead and leave that foot on the ground. Inhale, come back, you sit up straight. Exhale, you're gonna come into that C shape, so you're gonna tuck that tailbone. Deep breath in, exhale. Deep breath in. Deep breath in, two more, one each way. Last time. And all the way up. Lovely, hands on the ground, elbows find their way to the ground. We're gonna tuck the tailbone and roll all the way up. Nice. And let's put the feet on the ground and we're going to leave those hip flexors right now. So take a deep breath in. Simply lift the hips from the ground. Coming into this nice plank position. So from the knees to the hips to the ribs to the shoulders, I have a nice straight line. I'm going to use my arms and my hands to push into the mat. A little tuck in the shoulder blades, but don't roll out of the shoulder heads. Now, take that Pilates breath. There's a challenge to this, I think. Easy to lift the pelvic floor, gravity in your favor. Easy to draw the navel towards the spine. The tough part, I think, is to breathe laterally because all those organs have come up in your face there. So when you take that strong exhale, get them out. Push them back. One more. All right, lift the right heel. Using the hands for support and the arms, bring that right knee into your chest and lower it down. We go the other side. Left knee, drop it down. You don't have to lift to the heel, which is an easier way to think about it. In and out. In and back down. Again, squeezing the glutes and back down. One more time. I never ask for very much, just good form. Roll back down. Bring the knees in.
one leg up and the other leg down just a little bit. Now, you don't have to straighten the legs. You can keep them bent. You can take them deeper. It's entirely up to you. You can take the head up or take the head down. But we take a deep breath in.
And exhale. Here's that strong exhale now. And
give that leg a little ever so slight pulse to you. Oh, very nice. Good strong exhale. The last four. That belly's moving down. One more. All the way in. Let's take the soles of the feet together and let the sides of the feet, the legs open. The soles of the feet come together and just stretch. Reach the arms out over your head as well. And while I'm here, I'm going to look at the clock. Okay, so roll over onto your side facing me. So we can get this down first, right? We're going to take what I call banana boat first. It's a little more oblique work today, and I want to know next week if you were sore in your obliques. You can take your hand on the ground. I'm going to take the other hand underneath my head here for support. Take a deep breath in, exhale, lifting the feet first. Another deep breath, exhale, lower them back down. So just the feet are lifting first. Deep breath in, legs are long. Exhale, inhale, exhale back down. So what I want you to notice is have the feet move forward and your hips move back. And if that's the case, push the feet back and the hips forward. All right, so you're keeping this nice straight line. Deep breath in. Exhale, lift, and release back. All right, so now we're going to lift the whole upper body with the feet. Like, deep breath in, exhale.
How did I do that? Was it all, might have been all the way down. I'm not sure.
Exhale.
Oh, jeez. Exhale.
That's interesting. I can't remember how I did that before. Exhale. Oh, yeah, I guess so. Just use the hand right there. Release back. Deep breath in. Exhale. Inhale down one more time. Exhale, lift. Release back down. Bring the knees up. And we'll take that clam. So support your head right here. And just lift and lower that top leg. Easy enough, right? Hips are staying stacked up. You're going to use, you feel this muscle in the back get tight when you do that. You're going to use it. One more. Right, so now we're going to lift the whole leg without letting the hip move back. So imagine you are up against the back of the wall right there. Flex the feet if you need to. Point the toes if that feels better. I have to go through both because my legs sometimes cramp up. And here, two more. Last one. All right, so now arms out in front. Going to lift the fingers to the ceiling and then exhale, opening up. Now, this is not a chest stretch at all. You're going to work at dropping the shoulders down to the mat. Don't let the hand drop to the mat. Come right back. Deep breath to the ceiling. Exhale, close. Inhale to the ceiling. Exhale, drop the shoulder back. You may not get that shoulder to the mat. Inhale to the ceiling. Exhale, close. Two breaths. Inhale. That strong exhale in the rib cage supports your spine in this twist. One more time. Inhale. And exhale. All right, push yourself up. We'll take spinal stretch forward, then we'll go to the other side. So legs to the front. Take a deep breath in. You've got this imaginary ball right here, or a block, sitting nice and tall. Exhale, scoop the belly, stretch the little fingers forward. On the next inhale, reach forward more, but pull back on that navel. And then inhale, come back. So it's a two-breath cycle. That pelvis is going to stay perpendicular to the ground. I'm not going to hinge at my hips when I come forward. It's the C curve in the top, all right? Nice deep breath in. Exhale. Now, inhale, reach forward, but somebody's pulling you back in the middle. And exhale, come back up. Deep breath.
Inhale, navel comes in, stretch further. Exhale, back up. Breath. Navel comes in, stretch further. Exhale, back up. One more time. Stretch further. This time, reach to the ceiling, all the way up. And I'm going to, let's see, you're going to want to be on the other side. So walk your feet around. And then I want you to roll back down so you'll be on the other side, I think, right?
Yes.
Okay, good. Yes. Perfect. So all the way down on the side, we're going to take this banana roll first. I don't know the name of it. That's what I call it. So my feet are long here, all right? I'm all the way down. I'm not hinged or piped in the middle. They're all the way down. Take a deep breath in. Exhale. We're going to start first with the feet. Let them go. Deep breath in again. And they lower back down. Breathing in. Exhale, lift. You're using this oblique right here. Take another deep breath in. Exhale, back down. If you find length in those